Welcome everyone, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to be looking at some puzzles involving measurements, especially having to do with volumes. So a lot of these questions here are very classical. In fact, they often have very rich histories going back even to medieval times. So these are clever puzzles that have a broad appeal to a wide variety of people, and they're especially suited for getting young children thinking about some basic logic things having to do with liquids and pouring liquids from one thing to another. And there's some elementary, usually additive arithmetic involved, so we're strengthening also our understanding and appreciation of number arithmetic. So to get us started, let's have a look at this puzzle here. You have a 3-cup glass and a 4-cup glass. There's a 3-cup glass, there's a 4-cup glass. And a source of water, a tap. So how are we going to get one of the glasses containing exactly 2 cups of water? The idea is that we're allowed to fill up a cup. Okay, we can fill it right up to the top, and we're able to pour from one glass to another without spilling. But we can't just estimate. So what we'd like, for example, is to have exactly half of this. But we are not allowed to just take this glass here of 3 cups and kind of pour in and sort of guesstimate and say, okay, now it looks like we're halfway. All right, that's not an exact solution. It might be approximate, but not exact. So we want to do something a little bit more clever than that. Okay, so here's a solution to this problem. So step one, fill the 3-cup glass. Step two, pour it into the 4-cup glass. So we've poured it into there, and so we have 3 cups in the 4-cup glass. Third step, fill the 3-cup glass again for the second time. And now, fill the rest of the 4-cup glass from the 3-cup glass. So we take this one here, and we just pour enough into the 4-cup glass to fill it. So at what point now are we? Well, the 4-cup glass is full. It had 3 cups previously, so we must have added 1 cup to fill it. That means that the 3-cup glass has been reduced by exactly 1 cup and must therefore contain 2 cups. So, 2 cups remain in the 3-cup glass. That's a solution to our problem. And we can actually do that by pouring liquids from one to the other. And this is something that if you have a 3-cup glass and a 4-cup glass, you could actually do in practice and exhibit the solution physically. Our second puzzle is just a variant on that one. We have 2 containers now of 5 and 8 cups. And again, we want to end up with one of them just having exactly 2 cups. So we'll leave that one for you. Okay, our third puzzle, with the same containers of 5 and 8 cups, we now want to fill the larger one with exactly 6 cups. So here's a 5-cup container, here's an 8-cup container, we have a source of water as before, and somehow we want to end up with exactly 6 cups in the larger container. Now this is a very classical problem. It goes back to medieval times, to around 1484 at least. Okay, so people have been thinking about this kind of thing for a long time. So this is an excellent little logical puzzle to work out involving elementary kinds of arithmetic, which is really just additive arithmetic. It does involve subtraction sort of indirectly, but you don't have to phrase things using subtraction. We can think about it purely just in terms of numbers and adding numbers. What do you have to add to this number to get this number, etc.? Okay, so even a kindergarten student could, if they spent some time and were given some encouragement, maybe some hints, could work their way to try to understand what's going on with this kind of interesting puzzle. All right, so here's our solution involving a step-by-step procedure. I haven't given you any pictures, but I hope you can follow along the logical structure. So first of all, we fill the 8-cup. That's the 8-cup glass. Now we use the 8-cup to fill the 5-cup. So we pour the contents of the 8-cup in to fill the 5-cup, leaving 3 cups in the 8-cup, because 5 plus 3 is 8. Now we pour out the 5-cup. We've got it full, but we just pour it out. We don't need that. Now we pour the 3 cups from the 8-cup into the 5-cup. So we just transfer those 3 cups into the 5-cup. Now we fill the 8 cup. And finally, we fill the rest of the 5 cup from the 8 cup. So currently there's 3 cups in the 5 cup. The 8 cup is full. We pour enough in to fill the 5 cup. In other words, we have to add 2 cups to go from the 3 cups to the 5 cups. So we have to pour out 2 cups from the 8 cup, leaving 6 cups in the 8 cup. Simple arithmetic. Relatively simple, but you have to visualize things. You have to understand this, then this, then this. That's not so easy for young people to do, but it's something they can learn to do. So if you go slowly through this, especially if you have some actual bottles or something in front of you and you can actually do this physically, then that's great. They can actually see it happening, okay? So they can appreciate the step-by-step approach that we have to navigate our way towards what we want. Okay, our next problem is a little bit trickier. So our puzzle number 4. This is a classical problem that goes back to medieval times. Okay, so it has a very rich history. We could call it the 3 jugs problem. And it will definitely be a challenge, okay? The younger children may find it too hard, but the older children, especially the ones with a bit of mathematical ability or motivation, will find it great fun. Okay, so we have 3 jugs of capacities, 3, 5, and 8 cups. Now, we don't actually have to use cups, but cups are convenient for these problems because they're shared by both the metrical system and the imperial or U.S. systems. Okay, but you could use 3, 5, and 8 pints, or 3, 5, and 8 liters, or something like that if you wanted to. Okay, so initially the 8 cup jar or container is full and the others are empty. So we're starting off like this. This one is full. And using exact pourings, so pourings where we know exactly where the water is going. So we're either pouring till the container that we've got is empty, or pouring until whatever we're pouring into is full. So we're not starting at some point and then stopping at some intermediate point where we're guessing at something like that. And there's no guessing involved here, all right? Just as before. So using exact pourings, we want to get 4 cups of water each in the 2 larger jugs. So we want to end up with exactly 4 cups in the 5 cup jar and exactly 4 cups in the 8 cup jar. But we want to do it exactly. Okay, so this does require some work. It may take you a little while to figure out how to do it. I'll give you a hint. 7 pourings are needed, as far as I know. Don't think there's a simpler way. All right, so 7 pourings are going to be required. Okay, so here's a puzzle that I made up. I hope it's correct. Show that with 3 containers of 2 cups, 3 cups, and 10 cups, we can obtain any volume from 1 cup all the way up to 10 cups, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or 10, subject to the following rules. So any of these containers can be filled from the tap anytime. So filling container is free. We can do that any time we want. But at most 2 pours from one container to another are allowed. So 1 pour, 2 pours, that's all. No more than 2 pours are allowed. Okay, and we now have to show that we can get any volume from 1 cup up to 10 cups with these 3 containers. Containers of 2 cups, 3 cups, and 10 cups. I think this kind of puzzle is not as popular or often seen as it probably should be. So the idea of asking someone to do a series of things, okay? Not just solve one thing, but to solve a whole bunch of things, one after the other, hopefully in some kind of methodical, organized way. And it's very valuable, especially for young children learning mathematics, where doing something systematically is really good. And the idea of doing once, doing twice, doing 3 times, building on the experiences that we start with to go further. That's, I think, a very powerful kind of orientation. Okay, so here is a kind of a solution. I've done most of the cases, but not all of them. So suppose we want to get one cup. This is also a way of illustrating what it is that I want you to do, okay, in case it's not entirely clear. So we have 2, 3, and 10 cups. These are our representations of them. And I'm sort of geometrically or physically sort of demonstrating what we're going to do. So we want to get a one cup. That's the first step. How do we get one cup out of these things? Well, that's actually easy. We only need the 2 and the 3 cups for that. What we're going to do is we're going to fill the 3 cup. That's what that shows. So the 3 cup is now filled. And this arrow here means that we're then going to pour the contents of the 3 cup into the 2 cup. Okay, so we go from here to here. We've poured some of the water from the 3 cup to fill the 2 cup. And then what's left over in the 3 cup is obviously 1 cup. So we've created 1 cup and we've done actually only 1 pouring. Okay. 2 cups, oh, that's too easy, we just fill the 2 cup. 3 cups, that's also too easy, we just fill the 3 cup. How about 4 cups? Well, that's not too hard. We fill the 2 cup once and pour it into the 10, giving that. And then we fill the 2 cup again and pour it in again, and we get a total of 4 cups in the larger container. How do we get 5? Well, that's also easy. We fill the 2 and the 3 cups. And then we pour both of them into the bigger container, ending up with 5 cups in the bigger container. How do we get 6 cups? Well, we just use the 3 cup twice, kind of an obvious way, and we end up with 6 cups. And I'll leave the other ones to you. How about the 9 cup? Just to illustrate that. So to get the 9 cups, what we're going to do is we're going to fill the 2 cup and the 10 cup, and then we're going to pour the 2 cup into the 3 cup. Okay, so at that stage now, there will be 2 cups in the 3 cup. And now we're going to pour some of the 10 cup into the 3 cup. There's exactly 1 cup more room in the 3 cup. So when we pour the 10 into here, one of them will go in there, and that will leave us 9 in the 10 cup. So that's how we get exactly 9 cups in the final container. Okay, so none of the steps are hard, but, you know, we have to try different things for different cases, and we can go systematically from 1 to 10. And that's a kind of a satisfying exercise, and it's maybe a little bit pleasant mathematically that these 3 containers, exactly these sizes, allow us to do this. So here's a variant of that previous problem, still involving these 3 containers of 2, 3, and 10 cups. So show that with free fills and at most 2 pours, just as last time, we can actually get a total volume of any number from 1 to 15 cups if we allow the end product to use more than just 1 cup. Okay, so if we allow ourselves to combine volumes from more than just one of the cups, because after all, the maximum volume of any one of them is 10. So for example, what I mean here, suppose we wanted to get 11 cups, okay? So what we would do is we would fill the 3 and fill the 10, and then pour the 3 into the 2. So at the end of that, the 2 would be full, and there would be 1 cup left in the 3, giving us a total of 11 cups between the 3 and the 10 cup containers. Okay, so you can show that we can get all the volumes up to 2 + 3 + 10, which is 15. So that's kind of a pleasant extension of the previous problem. And our final puzzle is sort of the same kind of territory. We're asking, are there any other choices of 3 containers sizes that will allow us to accomplish this kind of thing? So if we wanted to use 3 containers and be able to find exact volumes from 1 all the way to 15 with free fills but at most 2 pours, then are there any other choices of numbers that we could use? So it's a bit more open-ended. So this suggests, I guess, that there might be lots of other interesting pouring problems, and there are lots of problems in this direction. So that's some fun to be had, connecting arithmetic with actual playing around with water, which is fun. In our next video, what we want to do is we want to go back to our basic arithmetic, because after all, we haven't really practiced our arithmetic that consistently yet. So we need to strengthen our understanding of basic addition, okay? So we're going to think about how we can train our young people to become really fluid with addition. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norman Wildberger. Thanks for listening.